clinician working with adolescents, I've started to realize how important it was to start to understand the impact of electronic media, the internet, BBM, all sorts of things on young people. It is very difficult for us old persons to understand how much there's been a radical change in relationship even between young people because of these new tools. In the past, adolescence was really a time of emotional secrecy, discretion, and sometimes physical exuberance. Now, young people tend to share their emotions, their thoughts, their love, and to expose it to the world through Facebook, through the internet, from very personal comments, texts, but also pictures of them that in the past we would have hidden or maybe shared only with a few friends. This also has led to a possibility to get in touch with anybody at any time. In the olden days, maybe school times was when you interacted, but then you were back home. Now, at 11 p.m., your phone starts to blip because somebody has said something about you, and then suddenly your whole group of friends is starting to comment. Not only this, but adolescence was the time where your sense of identity and also of sexual identity was developing. Nowadays, anybody has access to material which 20 years ago, 25 years ago, was limited to paying adults. Therefore, they're going to have to come to terms with images which at a certain age can be traumatic, but also lead sometimes to absolutely surprising expectations with regard to what is okay or not, and how one should behave with one boyfriend or girlfriend. More deeply than this, there is an issue about the development of what I would call identity, subjectivity. The psychoanalyst Jacques Lacan talk about the mirror stage as a key phase in the development of personality. This mirror stage is when the child, a toddler, for the first time recognizes himself or herself in the mirror. This is me. And it is a very important moment because before that, you had a sense of yourself, but then you start to assume an image. I mean, you're also this. And you become aware that what you see in the mirror is what others see of you. So you have to take into account reality, but also a very strange aspect of reality, which is your image. This image you can manipulate, you can dress up, you can put some makeup on yourself, but at the same time there is something that you can change, which is the reality of your body. How tall you are, how blonde or dark haired, how fast, how muscular, how pretty. You negotiate something with that sense of reality. One of the problems that we see now is that when you are dealing with friends through the internet, very often you can manipulate this image. You can change it. And the extreme example is represented by some games in which you are actually on screen an avatar. You're an electronic creature, and the quality of this creature you determine, you invent. Now, if you can be powerful and fast and beautiful and clever and always winning for hours and hours, and also in your interaction with friends, how is this going to impact on the sense of self when you are back to reality, where you're playing, when you're having fun with real others? What do you expect of them, but also what do you expect of yourself? And it is very possible that the very nature of the electronic media is having an impact on the development of structures that we psychoanalysts would call the ego ideal or narcissism, which actually means, in simple terms, the image of yourself, what you expect of yourself, your value, but also your hopes, your plans, your expectations in life. How could you deal with the change that this involves? Is there a massive disappointment then in reality when, having been world champion footballer on FIFA game, then suddenly you can't kick a ball? Or you realize, you may discover over the years, that to kick a ball you need to learn, where actually on screen it's a completely different process of learning. It's a learning that is actually transferable from one game to the other, largely. So suddenly you discover that to be as good as you thought, you're going to have maybe to make an effort, to work, to discover and to accept that you don't know, which is the first step towards knowledge. Could it be that it is that sort of electronic impact that explain why nowadays young people want to be celebs? But do they have a skill? Can they sing? Can they act? Can they play? Maybe not. Does it matter? No, because actually what you want is the status, not necessarily the apprenticeship, the long process, and actually mastering the skill and the qualities required. So there is a divorce between reality and the imaginary world. This divorce always existed, but in the past, the reality principle brought you back to a more humble or realistic position. Nowadays, there is an enormous amount of frustration because what you have experienced as real life, but is in fact a virtual life, does not fit your experience of your real life. How much is this connected with not just disappointment, but psychopathology? It's something that we are going to discover probably over the next 10 to 20 years. But it's very important that clinician, professional, start to think about this modification already now.